Nerd Kerf Episode 5, Google Calendar. I meant to add in my previous episode, if you're wondering how I learn all this stuff, I actually follow the Gmail blog, gmailblog@blogspot.com, and I think I follow the Google Calendar blog and a bunch of different blogs. I put their feeds in my Google Reader, and so you'll see here's the new, you know, they're talking about a new feature in Labs, and I just keep up with this, and when they have a new announcement, I go read it. So that makes things easy. Here I am in my Google Calendar, and probably the first thing I should talk about are all the different categories. Google calls them different calendars, but I think that it kind of makes more sense to think of them as categories. So each category of life has a different color. They don't have custom colors yet. I'm still waiting on that. Hint, hint, Google. But they do have a nice variety. You can see the variety they have down there. So this is my default calendar that comes with your Gmail address. And if you want more calendars, you just click this Create button. So my green Katherine Younger calendar is kind of the default stuff of my life. It's stuff that I don't really notice the green anymore because it's background. The orange appointments, this is where I have to be. I have to get a TB test for my dietetic internship. And I have this gardening project I'm working on. So anywhere there's an orange, and if you look at last week, I had a run and lunch and study date. The orange is all ones that are events that I have to be somewhere. Then I have my class schedule as one, a category right here. Some of my courses, my tests are all in red. Here's Matt's calendar. I can see his and he can see mine. Meals and workouts and tasks. So if you come over here, you can see all the different little events clicked on. I use this 7 a.m. slot as a way to send myself reminders. So I put my gather and breathe posts in, spring pad announcement that I was supposed to make today, and I have it set up to auto remind me in this calendar. So if you come over here to settings, calendars, and look at the Katherine Younger for notifications, I have it set up so it will automatically email me 10 minutes before an event. So this is how I never forget things, is I put them in my calendar and I know that I'm going to get an email when it comes up, and then back in my email I always remember to blog about it, write about it, whatever the event is. Here I have don't forget to pack lunches and the video camera. When we head off to Bald Head Island, I have my sister's airline flight in here. So it really helps organize information, not only in appointment form, but things that you want to remind yourself of. You can see I have my meal plan down here. I do that in purple, and that's shared with Matt, so he can check from his iPhone. He can see what we're having for dinner that night. If I'm making something, pretend I have to soak some beans 24 hours in advance or thaw something from the freezer, I will actually go in here and create a reminder 24 hours in advance, and I'll get an email that says, you know, we're having beans with whatever 2 nights from now, and don't forget, it'll remind me to do something for that dinner. And in the description area, I'll also, if I'm making a recipe that, you know, I've saved on my spring pad or is at a blog, I'll like link to the specific blog post, so I'll have the recipe right there. Also, I have this nice feature, I think it's this weather calendar, but actually it might be in the settings, where you can click and see the weather forecast. So that's kind of nice. So if you go to settings, I think it's show the weather right here. Yes. Show it or don't show it. And you can also come back and look at the different views, I guess, week, month, 3 weeks. And tasks, actually, if you assign a date to a task, like right here, it will show up as actually a task that you can check off, just like that. So that's pretty cool, although I don't use it as much as I should. So you can see that my life is pretty busy, but everything is set up as auto reminders, and I check my calendar at least once a day. And I hope that helps explain Google Calendar a little bit better.